large studios controlling both film production and distribution began to dominate the film industry during the 1910s, but that didn't keep independent filmmakers from trying to get into the game. In 1913, a group of optimistic entrepreneurs traveled from Shadron, Nebraska to Deadwood, South Dakota. They were looking at locations for a movie they hoped to make with their newly formed Black Hills Feature Film Company. A cameraman filmed them as they walked the snowy streets of Deadwood. They hoped a movie would bring some money to Shadron.
Everyone was very excited about the prospects. The whole movie making industry was just kind of starting out at the time and was still in its infancy, yet established enough that a project like this could actually be pulled off. They believed that they had the perfect setting for Western.
In 1915, they released a 7-reel feature film, an exceptionally long movie for the day. It was about a particular period in South Dakota history and that period's most famous characters. The movie tells a highly fictionalized story about the lives and times of Wild Bill Hickok and Martha Jane Canary, better known as Calamity Jane. The villain in the film, Jack McCall, spoiler alert, was Hickok's real-life killer.
Well, it's a landmark in that it's a terrific example of a local talent film. It is an entirely Nebraska product. It was a company, a filmmaking company in Omaha that actually provided the technical expertise of filming it and editing it.
Although most of the movie was shot in and around Fort Robinson near Shadron, they did bring their camera to Deadwood for some key scenes. Just as Buffalo Bill and other producers had done, the Shadron group turned to the U.S. Army for extras. They evidently didn't have enough money for period uniforms, so these Fort Robinson soldiers are dressed in the duty outfits of 1914 and 1915. The producers also hired Native Americans from Pine Ridge, but they didn't have a lot to do in the movie.
I think that they were looked at to some degree as scenery, and that they probably thought to themselves, oh, this will be interesting. We'll show these Native American women and children in camp, and we'll show the teepees, and it will be an interesting visual. I think that was pretty much the limits of their thought.
The trip from Pine Ridge to Shadron was a short hop over the border, but leaving the reservation wasn't that simple at the time.
These directors or producers would have contacted the reservation agent and asked the agent if it was all right to release or to give a pass to these named individuals to come to wherever, whether it's LA or Deadwood or Shadron.
The plot of the film is almost purely fictional. A romance between Wild Bill and Calamity Jane that never happened in real life is a key component of the story. It's a melodrama.
The construct of the hero and villain, this is an interesting film in that there's a heroine as well, Calamity Jane, although she's nothing like, in real life, she was nothing like this figure, really. Gunplay, gambling scenes, mining scenes, those kinds of things made up Westerns of that era.
The adults of 1915 would have been the children of the frontier, and they would have known the local history, not just from newspapers and the fiction and dime novels. The film reflects that blend of history and myth.
We would call it myth-making, but they thought they were telling a truthful story, although we don't really think, historians today don't think of Calamity Jane as a heroine, or there's controversy about Wild Bill Hickok as well, you know, did he shoot McCandless in the back kind of thing. But they thought they were being true to what was really happening.
Perhaps the most amazing thing about the Shadron film is that it exists at all. All 7 reels of the original 35mm cellulose nitrate film are now at the Library of Congress. Film and video copies of the original are housed at the Nebraska State Historical Society archives.
Well, we learned of its existence from a person who lives here in Lincoln, and he had found it in a antique dealer's collections in South Dakota. Of course, he was able to kind of put together that this was something that we might be interested in, and so we were able to purchase the film from this gentleman. As was common back then, only one copy was made, and that was it was the original that we were talking about here. So we were very glad to get it.